Describe the observance of Jewish ritual and law in your home.
There were two levels. There was one level in which Bobby Hashe was doing these things, and there was another level in which Papa was doing it. Papa wanted to, he was always interested in science. He wanted to become an engineer at one point. He liked, along with the spiritual stuff, he liked to also have the scientific explanations of things. One day, Papa left me in charge of my younger siblings on Shabbos. They had to go to a particular bar mitzvah or something like that. And so I was babysitting at that time. I wasn't more than 8 years old, but I already had seen some adventure movies and stuff like that too. So when Papa came home, he found me with a chopping knife, with a cleaver in the hand and with a broom in the other, standing next to the oven and in a puddle because I had peed in my pants. So what's going on? I said, Bubby had told me that you mustn't touch the stove, the oven, on Shabbos, because there was a snake curled up inside, and the snake would bite you if you opened the stove on Shabbos. What she wanted me to do is observe not to touch the stove on Shabbos. I had to go and pee, so I was afraid to leave my siblings alone with the snake being inside the oven. So I opened the oven, waiting for the snake to come with the cleaver in one hand and with the broom in the other, and I was going to take the broom, put it over the head of the snake and chop off his head and then go pee. But the snake never came out. So Papa saw me this way. He made me change quick, cleaned me up, and took me by the hand and grabbed me and took me down the street in a fury until he came to Omama's house, to grandmother's house. And they were sitting at the table having the Shabbos meal together, and Papa storms into the room and says, Zugim dem emes! Tell him the truth, you know? So she says, Vos der emes, vos habach im getin, chav chukun, vos fischte for me, vos whatever. He says, is there a snake in the stove or there's not a snake in the stove? You know? And he didn't let off until she admitted that she had told me a lie in the service of wanting my observance better. And he says, you hear? He says to me, you hear? Don't believe such stuff anymore. There is no snake in the stove. Come home. Well, he was so bruges, so angry at this, and I'm glad this was a wonderful experience to debunk. So Papa, Papa could get into a fury. He was a kohen. That was part of his, a beza kohen. When he got into his fury, it was strong.
What was your favorite Jewish holiday as a child?
I liked all of them. Simchas Torah was always fun. Purim, so-so. You know, I would get dressed up several times. I would borrow from the women who were working for us, babysitting and so on, borrow some dresses and high heels, and I'd walk down and be, you know, and got whistled at, you know. And that was fun, a little wig on. And, but that wasn't... That wasn't a happy fun. It was sort of a, you had to compete with the other people who were dressed. You had to make a little spiel, Heint des Purim, morgen ist Eis, and you had to go so what's your shtick today? You know, and you had to do your shtick. So I had my shticks there. Some of them were these skits that almost everybody had about the guy who's in front of the judge who says to him, what is your name? And he says, Leiser. You know, say, give him the Yiddish name, but it also in German means speak softer. What is your name? and the last name is Lauter, which means louder. So, you know, so you had all these curious, fun things to do. That was Purim. But Simchas Torah I liked.
Describe it.
Well, the dancing was always wonderful, but one Simchas Torah, they decided to give the people who get called to the Torah funny hats. And so everybody had to wear a funny hat when they got called to the Torah. They called Papa to the Torah, and they gave him a funny hat, which was this kind of German army with a pointed thing there. And in front of it, they had a string, and on the string was an egg that had been blown out, but filled with plaster of Paris, so it was pretty heavy, and on the string. And it was so that if you would chuckle in the davening, it would bang you in the nose. So they put this on Papa's head and call him, and you called him to the Torah, and Papa goes, Baruch Hu Es Hashem Baruch, and hitting the people to both sides. And I still remember that with joy.
Do you recall a particular Passover?
They didn't stand out at that time. We didn't have many guests for Passover. You know, the family was together. Parents worked very hard. One thing I do remember on Passover that impressed me a lot, the woman who was sort of the servant person who took care of the family and the dishes and stuff like that. On Passover, she was asked to sit in a place of honor. She wasn't to serve on that day, as a sign that we went out of Egypt and we were freed, and that was very impressive. Each one of us would get the job of serving her plate.
How was lagbomer celebrated in your community?
Outings. We would go for an outing. Most of them would be a football game, a good football game. For fun, we would sometimes make bows and arrows and try and shoot at a target. Nothing that special for lagbomer.
Who made your first pair of tefillin?
Who made mine? Papa was... About tefillin, Papa Olav HaShalom had a very strong sense. He wanted me to have a very good pair. So he bought a pair of tefillin, and then that was his job for all the grandchildren, you know. And that's become my job now, too, to provide the children, the grandchildren, with a pair of tefillin. So he went... to a sofer who had imported them from Tisminitz in Poland, which were a pretty good pair of tefillin, yes.
When was your bar mitzvah?
It was Parshat Ekev in Veslau, which was a summer resort where we went to, and in that little shul there. That summer resort was close to a place called Baden by Wien, which was a sulfur bath. The chief rabbi of Baden was Rabbi Naftali Karlebach. Once I was sent in with a chicken to check whether it was kosher or not, and I met Shlomo and Elichaim Karlebach there, and that was our first encounter. We played a little football there, and that's when I first met him. So, yes, this was... So, in Veslau, I did my portion of the Torah reading and the Haftorah, and I davened Musaf, and that was just wonderful. I gave a little speech that my bar mitzvah teacher had written for me. Nothing that I would remember very much today.